The U.S. is rebranding in Africa in response to China's power on the continent. Now, this week, President Yoweri Kaguta Museveni is in the U.S. to attend the U.S.-Africa Summit. With me is Daniel Karibuije to discuss this. The U.S. is rebranding in Africa in response to China's emerging power. And we saw earlier at this summit the different white officials come out to stress the need to strengthen ties with us. But we know that Africa has been complaining about the conditional help we've been getting from the U.S. Are we now likely to see U.S. cave in as China is making inroads in Africa?
Of course, thank you. These pressures are real. There are a lot of geopolitical and economic interests. And the U.S. and China, of course, they are superpowers. The U.S. is the world's number one economy. Number two is China. Yes. So there are different geopolitical and economic interests at play. And when two elephants fight, they say the grass suffers. But in this case, it's actually an opportunity, you know, because you have two different powers trying to compete for attention in Africa. So I think we're in a privileged position because it means that we have options. You know, we can trade with the U.S., we can trade with China. The U.S. knows that they can't take Africa for granted anymore. That's why the U.S. Secretary of State, Antony Blinken, has said that the future Africa is going to model the global future of the world in terms of trade and many other aspects. And the U.S. Secretary of State making that comment says a lot. So Africa is not just going to shape the future for itself, but also for the globe. And Africa is indeed the world's most important investment and trade destination as I speak right now.
The U.S. National Security Advisor, Jake, told reporters that they were working with Congress to commit $55 billion to work closely with Africa over the next 3 years. Are we likely to see new deals come from this?
Yes, I think what will happen, it is good that the U.S. and China are competing for Africa.
Yes.
And my understanding is that most likely, I hope that the U.S. relaxes some of its conditionalities, especially those which are not trade-related.
Yes.
You know, because overnight they can just cut off a country and say, because of ABCD, you're not going to be allowed to export the the U.S. market because you have not fulfilled certain human rights obligations. And we hope that that does not become an issue for our trade, okay? Because in the past, we thought it was a small matter, but increasingly it's being hidden under human rights, and I hope that does not affect trade. One way of trying to gauge ourselves as a country is to look at what are other African countries exporting to the U.S. that we can produce ourselves. And if you look at Kenya, the majority of the exports to the U.S. are apparel. And apparel should be our number one priority for the U.S. market. And coffee is also very key. Organic coffee has a huge market in America. Most of exports to the U.S. are actually coffee in terms of single product. Spices, last year we exported $60 million of spices to the U.S. market. So spices, coffee, macadamia, and apparel should be number one in terms of value addition and manufacturing.
Now, Daniel, can you give a simple guide for someone to export from Uganda?
Yeah, I can give a simple guide. For starters, as much as possible, exporters or people interested in export trade need to engage in what we call market-led production. Find out what the market needs, then work backwards and produce it. Many people turn the other way around. They first produce a product and then begin to look for a market. That's not a good strategy. So I always encourage people to get involved in market-led production. Secondly, of course, you need to follow the formal channels of business. You need to register a company. You need to register a TIN. This company can have a business name or it can be a private limited company. And in addition, it's very important for you to follow the different forms of documentation. There's the pre-export documentation, which is stage one, then we have the shipping documentation, which is stage two. And under stage one, of course, there are different types of certification based on products, but also most importantly, there are about six products that are special in our economy that require licenses.
from Daniel's explanations here, it is very good that we have the US and China competing for Africa. And for us Ugandans in particular, we should be able to identify opportunities to export.